What's up, ladies and gentlemen? This is Volusia Show, aka Robert here, and this may or may not be, you know, my last video in a while. I got my buddy Alec with me.
What's up?
You might, yeah, some of you might have recognized him in that zipline video that I did a couple months back. I mean, we're not gonna do too much.
Gonna fall off of another zipline, am I?
Hopefully not. We're just gonna do some bowling and some random stuff. And if we have time, Alec might be able to like share what happened at the Holiday Hill.
They get canceled.
All right. So the dorm that I'm staying at, it fucking sucks. I mean, it's not the worst, you know, dorm ever, but like, it's like small. Like, you know, like on like one side, you know, it's like small. Like, when I'm, like, sleeping at night, it feels like I'm sleeping in a fucking coffin.
So you're basically sleeping with another dude in a coffin.
No.
Get out of the car. Get out of the car.
We have separate beds, Alec.
What's the fun in that, then?
We have each other's own space. We got snacks and stuff like that. You know.
If I don't see a mini fridge packed with PBR, I will be disappointed.
So yeah, we have a small ass fridge which can't really hold a lot of stuff.
Just enough for the methamphetamines.
Walter White.
If you're not Jesse Pinkman by the time you graduate, Robert, we have some serious problems going on here.
Yeah, another thing that I have to mention is that like the bathrooms are always hot, and I'm not kidding when I say this. Like for the freaking thermostat that they have. Like, they actually have, like, a cage where, like, nobody's allowed to change the temperature
in
the room.
Turn right on Cooley Street.
It's always at 75 degrees Fahrenheit.
Well, Robert, the reason it's so hot is because they have a lot of dudes there. And that's fucking hot.
Yeah. No homo.
Whoa. You just slipped up there, bud. Don't be sussy in the Tucson. It's already sussy enough in here.
Yes, very, very, very sussy. And also,
in 1.8
like,
miles.
This,
turn left
I heard
on
the freaking freshman orientation. Like, it was like towards the end of June, and I heard from like a peer advisor that, like, you know, she recommended that, like, we not take our, you know, that we don't be barefoot while taking a shower because she heard that, like, you know, there's like some kid had like foot infections and shit like that, and so I'm not gonna take the risk.
That's reassuring.
Yeah.
Could be hot, suck on those toes.
Yep, here we are. Good old Shaker Bowl. I haven't been to this place in years.
About to get kicked out.
Oh, yeah.
I'm about to leave this morning and they're like, Alec, go pick up stuff from the store. I gotta go.
Like,
no.
Alright, we're gonna be heading inside right now. I'll, like, I don't know. You can, like, record me do some bowling. I'll record you do some bowling. Some good stuff. A good name. Big. Big man. That's perfect. That's a perfect name.
Alright, you're up first, Timber. The bumpers are knocked down. I'm gonna prove to myself that I'm a real man.
A real boy. He's a real boy.
That was horrible, Alec.
We
you should be ashamed. You
we
should
don't.
Be ashamed of yourself, man.
Don't talk about.
I'm gonna disown
you. We don't talk
you.
About that. We don't talk about that. Okay? It's not something we talk about. You really just gotta line it up with the little arrow and just full set.
Yeah, I suck at bowling. We are tied. Bowl on Allen Street screens when you get a strike. Ah, so close. Alright, I'm gonna try and get that one.
We about to watch Robert miss.
I mean, if you get get all the pins, is it? It's a strike, though.
It's a spare now.
Oh, a spare, okay.
Yeah. Delete the video.
I hate my life.
Delete the video.
All right, we have 3 pins. Let's see if you miss her or not.
You never miss her. We do a little bowling.
All right, we're putting money on this next game.
Robert bowls a spare. I'm gonna go broke. Send it, Robert. All right, my wallet is still intact. Let's see him go again. He's professionally handling the balls. He has a lot of experience with that. Let's see if he can get it down the hole. That has been a long time life struggle for me. Depression.
Alright, if Robert gets a strike on this one, I'm fucking gay.
I will fuck a dude. Take a step in. Just gotta send it.
Okay. Alright, I'm gonna send it.
Try to align yourself with like the arrows, you know? So just try to throw it at that middle one. I don't think you're bringing your arm back enough. And bring it forward. Keep your arm straight almost. Yeah, keep your arm straight. Take the step with it, keep it back, and then just, you know, kind of like move with the hips. That should have been a strike. That should have been a strike.
Yeah.
I'm good. Step in with it. There he goes.
Yeah, boy.
Make it a spare, Robert. Make it a spare. I believe in you. I believe in you. You only got 7 more pins. Just send it.
Alright, apparently the buffers have to be set up because I suck at bowling so much. But it's okay.
I believe in you.
Hopefully I'll get a strike.
Believe in the bumpers.
Yeah! Yes!
Oh, Didn't even need the bumpers. Didn't even need the bumpers.
Strike, bitch.
Here we go. What a boy.
Let's go buy a gun after.
Yeah. If there's one thing that really bothers me about these videos is that like every time you screw up, somebody graphically dies on TV.
Yeah.
I did this for Walter White.
No.
I did it for Daddy Walt. Please take me with you.
So Alec, I don't know if this is like the appropriate place to tell. But...
First date?
No, not first date, but like, could you like tell about like, you know, what happened at Holiday Hill with the lesbos?
So Robert slipped a roofie to these chicks. They passed out in the canoe. Robert then went over, tipped over the canoe to try to, you know, drown them a little bit. After they fell to the bottom of the water, someone took notice. So, you know, the lifeguard came and all that. The lifeguard was like this like 6'3", 500 pound guy, like So then he tried to fight us. So Robert ran away, and he grabbed a stick from the woods. The other guy had a paddle. It got into like a big fight. So Robert got hit in the head a couple times, but he eventually took the stick and just stabbed it through this guy, like a nice spear through a marshmallow. That's how I would describe it. You could hear deflating, actually. So, you know, after he kind of, you know, killed the guy, went on a rampage, stole a bus, whipped it back to Cheney, and went to his last three classes.
I don't want to set the world on fire.
All right, so we just, we stopped at this Italian place, if you can, like, try and even see it. And, I mean, the dessert was pretty good.
Then turn left,
but the meatball grinder tasted like shit. I didn't like it.
You spud eater. He comes in, "Oi man, you got some little spuds for me to eat?" He's like, "No, we actually have culture. We serve Italian food." And this dude goes, "Oh, I guess we will go get the meatball grinder." Sits down and he's like, "Oh man, this is terrible. You can't take this guy anywhere. No culture, no good sense of food. He can't even bowl right, first off. And now he does this. I can't take it anymore."
Yes. I'm a disgrace, okay? I'm sorry. I am so sorry that I'm not an Italian, okay?
You should be disgraced. You really should be.
I mean,
I have no more to say to you. I have no more to say. Let's go buy a Gat.
My excuse is that, like, I've had meatball grinders before in the past, but, like, here just tastes like shit.
Well, you're on grinder, but still.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this concludes my blog, which, you know, if I'm going to be honest, I haven't really done in a long-ass time. You know, if we had more people with us, we would have done, you know, other stuff, but it doesn't really matter. So, yeah, you know, like, subscribe, and, yeah.
Smoke weed.
And I'll hopefully see you next time. Bye.